Good morning guys and welcome in this new episode of One Year With Film Only. Today we'll be comparing four different techniques to develop black and white film and see how it will impact the final result. Okay guys, so before we move on, I just want to let you know that it's going to be a bit different than usual. Normally when I do a video, I have a kind of script and idea of how I'm going to proceed. Today is going to be total improvisation, so bear with me. I hope it won't be such a mess. So for today's video, we're going to compare two different developers and two different development techniques. The first one is the Rodinal. So we're going to try the normal development and the stand development and see the difference between those two. And we're going to compare also the same year, the Ilfotech DDX, with the normal development and the stand development as well. So in total, we're going to have the four different techniques, and I'm sure we will have complete different results. The film we're going to use is the Ilford FP4. I've got this roll, so it's going to be a bit of a challenge because I don't have any bulk loader. I have saved here a few canisters. Whoops. I will have to find this one. I have here four empty canisters that I've saved. So I'm going to have to turn the room completely dark and load this, so it's going to be a bit of a challenge. I've done it once and it's a mess, so hopefully I can manage to get four of those film loaded with FP4, and then I'm going to shoot the exact same picture with the same settings using the Smena that I have here, and we're going to see what it looks like. Then I'm going to develop it throughout the day and I'm going to later scan and we're going to look at the result. So let's get started. Okay guys, the room so now is almost dark. I still have a bit of light leak to fix, but I'm gonna go in the bathroom and turn the light off. It should be okay to have the complete darkness. I'm gonna load these four canisters with the Ilford FP4, so I see you on the other side. Okay, back to the light guys. So loading those film was a real pain. It was a real struggle. So if any of you has a spare bulk loader, please send it to me because I don't want to do this again. So I had a small change in the plan because one of the canister was not winding the film back. So I'm gonna use only three rolls. And I put a bit more film into one, like this. I have enough to cut it in two and do two different development with the same roll. So the next thing we want to do now is to shoot those film. The problem is that we are in Ireland and the weather changed so fast that I'm going to try to do it as fast as possible to maintain the same exposure. So I'm going to build a small set and try to have in the frame something that is in the shade and something in with bright part, so we can compare the dynamic range in the images. This is the set as I have it in the viewfinder. It's certainly not the most interesting pictures that I've made, but it will be a good one to see how the developers react depending on the exposure. So on the south here we can see a bit of clouds and dark areas, and up on the north you can see a lot of sun. So hopefully we will have details in both of them. Now I'm checking outside the weather, and there are of course, as always in Ireland, clouds coming up. So I'm gonna load the camera and then shoot as fast as I can to maintain the same exposure with the three rolls. It's gonna be tough, but hopefully I can make it. While I was winding back the film into the second roll, into the canister, it got kind of jammed, or I don't know what happened, but all the film that you can see here got stuck inside the camera, so it's now exposed to light. I don't want to go through all the thing of putting the room dark and everything. Plan B, I have here my X-Pan that is loaded with a roll of FP4. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna switch the X-Pan to the 35 millimeter mode. Like this, I will have 36 exposure, and I'm gonna cut the roll in four and put it in the different developer. We're gonna start with the Ilford DDX. The idea is to, let me grab the roll, to open this canister, and I'm gonna let it in the changing bag. And I found this case for my glasses. Like this, I'll make sure that there is no light leak that will damage the rest of the film, because I'm gonna cut only a part of, because I don't need the whole roll. I've checked on the massive depth chart, and the dilution we're gonna use with the Ilfotec is 1+9. There is also the 1+4, but I don't have much left, and I've always developed with the 1+9 dilution, so I'm gonna stick to that for now. I'm gonna get everything ready, and we're gonna start developing our first roll. Okay guys, I'm done with the development and the scanning as well. It's been a few days since I started to record the video, but I'm done now with everything. We're gonna look at the computer now. I've sorted the images and put them together so we can have a look and compare the development technique and how it affects the images. I can already tell you there is a lot of difference, so let's jump into it and look at the computer right now. Okay, here we are. We have the four images. I'm going to present you each of them one by one. The first one we're gonna look at is this one on top left is the one with the rodinal and the normal development that was for 11 minutes. We can see that the shadow details is really not good. I think from all of them is the worst, but we do have quite a lot of information in the highlight. And the file is also quite sharp. I think there is a fair amount of details in the image. So I wouldn't rate this one too bad. It's kind of a keeper, but as you can see, we have a better images out there. The next one, it's this one on the right, is the DDX and the normal development, which was for 15 minutes. Here we can see it's really a pale image with a low contrast. We have a bit more information in the shadows, but it's too pale for my taste. And the highlights are almost blown out. We have really, really not much detail. You can see on the roof, you can't almost distinguish the lines here. And here we can see way more information. So I'm not really happy with that, which is funny because that's the development technique I've been using for since I started to develop black and white. And I'm probably gonna change right now because I can see that I can get much better result with other techniques. Okay, the next one is the Rodinal. Is this one? The DDX for 45 minutes. Here we see a lot of information in the highlights. I think that's the one that retained the most information in the highlights. And we still have a fair amount of details in the shadows as well. And it's way sharper than the normal development with DDX. You can see the edges on the plant here. It's much sharper. There is more contrast. And it's funny because usually stand development should give a kind of flat file, something like this. But here it's much more contrasty, and I think it's a characteristic of the DDX, because I've done that already in the past and got amazing looking image, really dense negative, and they look like this. So I think it's one of the properties of the DDX when it's used in stand. It gives like really contrasty and sharp images with a good amount of details in both shadows and highlights. So that's kind of a keeper for me. And the last one we'll look at is the Rodinal for the with stand development. Here we also have a good amount of details in the shadows, a bit less in the highlights. We are almost like this one, and probably even worse. I think we can't even distinguish the lines here at all. So maybe not the best one if you have a high contrasty scene, but it's kind of okay. I kind of like the look here, and it's also fairly sharp, maybe not as sharp as this one, but we have a good amount of details, I would say. So overall, I'm really happy with the DDX in stand development, but I'm not really surprised with that because I've already developed black and white negative in the past, and I think it was HP5 too, if I remember correctly, and I really love the look of the negative. So I think that's something I would do again, and it's really easy to just pour the developer in, you know, agitate 1 minute, and then you get your negative scan. You don't have to worry about it. Next thing I want to show you, I've prepared two things in Photoshop. Okay, you have here the same section of the image, so I think I've kept the same organization. The first one, so it's the Rodinal with normal development. Then we have the DDX in normal, the stand with DDX, and the Rodinal stand. Like this, you can really have a good comparison of the difference between those four. And when we look closer, I think I kind of like the details in the shadows in the Rodinal stand. But the counterpart is that we lose a lot of details in the highlight. So you have to decide what you want in your image, and it also depends on the scene that you are shooting. But if you are in a high contrasty scene, I would go for the DDX because that's the one that will retain the most information in both shadows and highlight, I would say. Maybe the Rodinal in normal is not bad, but I'm not sure I like the look of this negative. And it looks a bit more grainy, I'm not sure, but in some parts, it looks kind of grainy, so yeah, I would stick with the DDX here. And the next thing I want to show you is the image, but same organization again, but split in four. Like this, you can really compare, not really the shadows and highlight, but more the look of the negative. One thing I want to mention is that these are straight out of the scanner. I didn't do any post-process or nothing at all. They are straight from the scanner with the same settings. I'm gonna pop up a link here, like this, if you wanna see how I scan my negative. There is a video and an article that you can check out. But that's it, yeah. You can really get the look that you want. and see what you really like. Then if you don't really bother with dynamic range and stuff like that and just focus on the look of the development, this is a good way to see what you like. Again, the DDX normal, I used to do that a lot, but when I see that compared to other, I'm not really fond of. But one thing I notice is like the Rodinal normal, it seems super grainy. If you compare these two parts, this one has almost no information and it's completely blurry, but this one is way too sharp. I think it's the accutance, if I'm correct, and it's the micro contrast between the black and white points, let's say, on the negative, and it makes like edges really sharp, which create the grain. And I think here it's too high. So I really don't like those two. And here I don't have enough information in the highlight again, but I kind of like the kind of contrast we have. But for me, the best is again the DDX and the Sten. I'm not saying the other one are bad or what, it's just for my personal taste. That's what I like at the moment. Might change in the future because I always change my style and stuff, but yeah, that's what I like for now. Yeah, that's about it for me, guys. If you want to have a look at the images in details, I'll put up a link in the description to the article. Like this, you can compare by yourself, because maybe it's not easy on the screen on the video to really see what I'm talking about, but like this you can take time and look at the images in details. And if you want me to compare other film or development technique or anything, just let me know in the comment and I'll do my best to answer all your comments and questions. And as usual, guys, if you enjoyed this episode, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Until then, keep shooting and thanks for watching. Bye, guys.